Just finished a fantastic day filming for Top Gear website and the magazine with the Valkyrie and the DMR Pro as well. Just spoken to the race track organizer, the bloke in charge. 7 o'clock now. He says this is live until 9 o'clock. With marshals, with the ambulance here, I can still drive. That's it, the AMR Pro. 3.5 million of your earth pounds. I know how to start it. And well, there's that stuff over there. What would you do? What would you do?
Bahrain Formula One lights. And just look at how cool this car is. So we've no hybrid system now. So we're missing about 150 horsepower. So let's say we've got 1,000. We're also 150 kilograms lighter. We don't have any tire warmers, so they'll be a little bit well behaved. This is last tank of petrol stuff. What a machine! 6.5 litre.
So, the AMR Pro. Don't think of this as a track version of the road car. It's a stillborn racing car. The only common parts are the engine and the headlights. That engine is a 1,000 horsepower 6.5 litre V12 from the road car, but with no hybrid system. The wheelbase
is 380 millimeters longer. Front track is 96 millimeters more, and the rear track is 115 millimeters more. The car is 266 millimeters longer overall. It's also claimed to have twice the downforce of the road car, and from the way it feels on the track, I'd say it's way more than that. There's also no fancy hydraulic suspension system. It's a simpler car. Apart from the start procedure, a small electric motor effectively bump starts the AMR Pro each time you get going. So really, it's just a racing car without any number plates. But how many other racing cars have a 1,000 horsepower, normally aspirated V12, that revs to 11,000 RPM?
We'd like to ask for a moment of your time.
Whoa.